Hello, musicians. Thank you for joining us. This is the fourth and final episode of our Spooky Soundscape series. Now, this is there's been three other tutorials on how to do all kinds of other things in order to build a soundscape that you can use to play at the back door when kids are coming to your house for treats, or maybe at the office when you want to have some kind of spooky background noises. Anyway, check out the other tutorials if you haven't seen them. And be sure to check out the channel because there are loads of tutorials up there on how to make spooky sounds. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to save this so that you can put it on an MP3 player or an iPad or whatever you're going to do, or a CD. Now, first thing we're going to do, you'll notice that I have my soundscape all completed and I have all kinds of tracks here. And I can manipulate these still, fine tune it at the end, but I'm going to save it first of all. Now, when you save it, you want to save it as a project first. This is not how you put it on a CD. This is not how you put it on an MP3 player. But if you save it as a project, it will save all of your tracks separately, all your settings separately. So that way you can come back and you can change this if you need to. So be sure to save it as a project as you work. But if you want to put it on a CD player or put it on an MP3 player, you have to check Export, File Menu, Export. Now, it's going to ask you for some metadata. This could be like the year it was done and the track name. You don't have to bother with this if you don't want to. So I'm going to click Find. I'm going to give it a name, first of all. I'm going to call it Spooky. Spooky. Now, and I'm going to save it on my desktop. Now, the file type is something that's going to be very important here. There's a video here, a tutorial, that you might want to check out that shows you the difference between WAV files and MP3 files and the saving process. You might want to check this out as well. It's important. It gets into a lot of details on why you choose certain file formats, so you might want to check that out. I'm going to talk to you here about two different file formats, MP3 and WAV. MP3 is good if you want to upload your file to the internet or you want to email it to somebody. Beyond that, I wouldn't bother saving it as MP3 because it's a compressed format. It'll lower the sound quality. And you went and spent so much time trying to find great WAV files to use as samples, you don't want to degrade it at the end of the day by exporting as an MP3. That would be such a shame. We're going to export it as a WAV file, and that's going to give us excellent quality. Excellent quality, the best quality we can get. So choose WAV file and click Save. And then that's going to produce a WAV file on your desktop or wherever it is you're going to save it. It may take a minute or two to export it, depending on how long it is, but be patient. Now, once that's done, you can import that file into iTunes or into Songbird or whatever it is that you're using, and you can use that to put on your MP3 player or on your iPod. You can also burn it to a CD if you have your favorite CD burning software like Nero or whatever it is that you use. You can then import this file that you just made, the WAV file, spooky.wav, into your CD burning software and save it as an audio CD, and then you can put it in any CD player and play it. There are lots of options. Depending on what you have, there are going to be different options, so I can't really get into that here because every single one of my subscribers will have a different setup. But once you have your WAV file, you can use it in all kinds of ways. So, import it into your favorite flavor of software, and then you can put it on your MP3 player or your DVD or your CD or whatever you like. There you go, that's it. Now, this has been fun. I hope you had a good time. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up for sure. Be sure to subscribe as well and check out all the other tutorials on how to make spooky sounds and other things with Audacity. Thank you for watching. I've had a great time, and I'll see you guys again.